I going to find that medallion? Even Mira stopped searching for it.
Maybe she found it already, and she's hiding it. Wasn't there a report that she went to a certain antique shop for the medallion?
It's not there anymore. Someone else had bought it.
How can you be sure that it wasn't Mira who bought it?
Anya, I'm sorry for what happened.
Dagon, they have discovered the letter. And Trudis wants to know who Wildflower is.
Anya.
Forget about your other women, Dagon. You're a married man now. You should be faithful to your wife. That's your obligation.
No, Anya. It was a mistake to marry Trudis out of pity. And not out of love.
So that's the reason why. You go and look for other women?
After 20 years of an unhappy marriage with her, I also have every right to be happy.
That's not fair. You don't have any right to hurt your wife just because you realized you made a wrong decision. Be a man, Dagon.
Trudis. Trudis, I'm sorry. Can we please just forget about the Wildflower? I'm not seeing her anymore. We're through. She's out of my life now.
If you heard them talking about your father, then why didn't you just ask them who he really is?
It's enough that I know that my father's name is Abel. I'll find him on my own.
Find him? How? But there are a lot of people named Abel in the Philippines. However, would you know who among them is your real father?
Hey, it looks like we have a visitor.
Maybe that's your father.
Excuse me, may I help you?
No, I was just passing by.
Dude, go ahead.
Okay, take care.
See ya.
We all know that the company is in a tight situation right now. Stocks are down and guests aren't quite coming in. For a prestigious hotel like ours, it baffles me why such problems are coming out.
Are you reading the newspapers, Mr. Fonseer? Do you know what's happening around the world? I know you've been out of the country, but I think you should realize that the company is getting affected by the global crisis. Or maybe you spend your time just reading the latest news on fashion.
Concerning ourselves with the world's problems won't help us. What we should do is focus on our problems first. Service. We are getting very poor reviews about the services that we give. That's why Ms. Madrigal and I have decided to create an evaluation system that will assess each and everyone's performance.
Wait, are you saying that you're monitoring each one of us?
Yes, and if you think you're doing a good job, you have nothing to worry about, right, Mr. Sadea?
Rafael, come and join us, son. Come on, let's eat.
Dad, I'm sorry.
You know what, Rafael? We've informed the insurance company of what happened to your car. They're looking into it now, so you have nothing to worry about, okay? Go and eat.
So now, get used to not having a car. Because I won't get you one till your grades improve. Go ahead. Eat. When you're done, I'll take you guys to school. But after class, go straight home. Straight home, Rafael. Understand?
Yes, Dad. I heard news about Star Hotel. It looks like their new president's taking some measures to improve their services.
That won't be an easy task. I'm sure someone's going to stop her there.
This early, I heard that the officer had a squabble. They hate Cassandra Madrigal. And worse, she doesn't show up.
In that case, we can take this situation to our advantage.
I think you're right. What kind of investors will believe in someone non-visible?
Aveni, mother! You see that man outside?
What man?
Presto and I saw him. He seemed like he was looking for something.
After we found out about Wildflower, Mommy has never been the same. She doesn't believe that it was just part of Daddy's past.
Don't worry, Nicole. I will help your mother get some peace of mind.
Mommy's getting on my nerves. Why doesn't she just leave Dad? Why does she have to bear all this, Aunt Anya?
If your mother argues with your dad, it might just lead to their separation. Do you really want to have a broken family?
I'd rather have that than this. There's always tension in the house.
If there's any way to save your mother and father's relationship, do it, Nicole. It's difficult to have a broken family. I've been there, and it's hard.
So, Mother, do you know that guy?
No. Vinny, do you think he's dangerous? Yeah, what are we going to do now?
If he's a burglar, then he's crazy. Then nothing's worth stealing here. Look at this place.
You think that even matters? Times are hard nowadays, so anyone can be robbed. Better safe than sorry. As soon as possible, we're moving.
What? Are you serious? Where will you get the money for that? I have no savings.
If we get in trouble, our neighbors will help us. And besides, I'm right here. I'll protect this house. I'll protect your mother.
That's my boy to the rescue. Yes!
But Anya, if your mother sees you, you'll also have to deal with Don Lucio. And when that happens, we don't know what might happen. It's not enough that you think you can handle him. He's a dangerous man, you know.
What a relief. Thank God you didn't go along with your mother's idea of moving out. It's not that easy to find a house these days. You know, your mother can be really crazy.
Aunt Fanny, I overheard you and my mother talking about my father.
What?
But don't worry, Aunt Fanny. I won't tell her anything. And if you won't tell me, it's okay. But I guess that's the reason why she wants to move out, right? She's not really afraid of burglars, is she? It's my father.
You know, you worry too much. Why don't you just finish that up while I take this upstairs?
Hey. What happened to you? Why do you look so glum?
I just feel sorry for Nathaniel.
Why? Did he say something?
Don't tell him that I told you. But he overheard our conversation about his father.
Does he know that I saw Abel?
No, but...
Just don't tell him, Vinny. I don't want them to see each other.
But what if he's the guy lurking outside?
You better come with me. I'm going to see him. I'm going to tell him to stop following me and my son around.
What? We're reshuffling positions? What are you trying to prove here? That we're not doing a good job?
The order came from the boss. We have no choice but to comply.
That's not fair. You will be demoting everyone here.
We're only doing this for the good of the company. Besides, if you don't like Miss Madrigal's management, we're offering an early retirement plan for all of you. You have the option to avail of it now.
Well, I think Miss Madrigal is right. Ever since she became the president, the hotel really picked up.
We should not allow an absent president to rule over us. No way!
Son, are you going out today?
No, Mother.
Good. Watch over the house, okay? Will you?
Okay.
We'll just be gone for a while.
Okay?
Mm. Mwah. Are you really up to this?
Of course, I want to get rid of this fear. I want to be at peace.
All right, but control yourself, okay?
Yes, leave it to me.
I think we're just wasting our time here. I don't think she'll be coming.
Hello? Speaking. Really? When? Later? Okay, count on it. I'll be there. I won't be late. Thanks. Yes!
What? Come on, let's talk to Abel. Come on.
No, no, wait. Hey, let's just stay here for a while.
Mira, are you okay?
Gary, let's go.
Oh, that's a good idea. I already fell asleep. Let's go.
The end of the alley, to the right. That's Mira's house.
You're sure that's Mira's house?
Positive.
And you're sure this is how they look like when they leave?
Yes, ma'am.
Because if you're not, you'll be sorry.
Come on. Come on, Vinny.
What? I thought you wanted to talk to Abel.
I'm sorry, but I'm not ready yet.
I knew it. You're still very much in love with him, aren't you?
Mira babes, welcome home! Wow! Mira babes, looks like we have a new costume now! Hey, what's wrong? Babes, hey babes, why aren't you talking to me? Babes, what's the matter?
Hey, huh? Gabby! It's too early for that, don't you think? Yeah, come on with me. I got to drive someone to the airport.
Okay, sure. Mira babes, I'll see you later, okay? I'll just be back later. Bye!
While I was watching them, I remembered my son. What if I gave Nathaniel to Abel before? Maybe he would have had a better life. You think I made a mistake, Vinny? Maybe I should have.
Mira, what you did was right. You know, you worry too much. For Nathaniel, you've been a good parent to him. Look, he grew up to be a good boy because of you. Well, aren't you really going to talk to him?
He can't have Nathaniel. Never.
Hurry!
Thanks, man. I knew you'd be able to help me.
Looks good on you, man.
And I didn't really expect that company to call me.
Don't mention it. Just do good at the interview, right? When they talk to you, remember to be really confident to really impress them, okay? Well, what are you applying for again?
Technical assistant, man. Wish me luck, okay? So I can save money for my tuition.
All right, good luck.
You're right. Don't be afraid of that guy. If he has plans of taking Nathaniel, well, sorry for him. I told you before, your son's all grown now. He can think for himself and he won't go that easily. And please remember this. Your son will never leave you. Savannah, it's not here. If it's with her, where did she hide it? Let's go.
Sis, I found it. Here's the reason why you keep dreaming about that dream boy of yours.
Later, brother. I'm in a hurry. I'll be late for our dress rehearsal. Excuse me.
I'm on my way. Yeah, well, I overslept. I told you, I'm on my way. I took a shortcut. Yes, I'm already wearing my costume, okay? All right, bye.
Nicole, please answer back. Even just a forwarded message. I need a sign from you.
Don't depend on that. If you really like her, go ahead and tell her. Texting are for sissies. You won't get anywhere with that.
You need any help? Drive?
Oh my god! It's you! You're real!
Yes! And look what you did to my clothes! You ruined my clothes! Now I'll never get hired!
Oh, I'm really sorry! I didn't know you were there! If you like, I'll just buy you new clothes or maybe I'll give you some money so you can buy a new one!
Thanks, but it won't be necessary.
We've ransacked that woman's entire house, and still no trace of the medallion.
At least, now we know that it's not with her.
That's my point. Then where will we look for it?
Let's go, guys. Come on. This is our last rehearsal. Places. Go! Why are you there? Come on! Hurry up, you two! Oh, finally! Juliet has arrived! Where have you been, Nicole? We've been worried sick about you. This is so unprofessional of you. The director was so pissed off. Nicole, what's wrong with you? Nicole?
Excuse me? I'm the applicant scheduled for an interview today.
Nathaniel Cordero?
Yes, sir.
You're late. I don't work with unprofessionals. You may leave.
Oh my god! What happened here?
Nathaniel!
Mira? Mira! Vinny?
Nathaniel's not here. Why that jerk? Do you think Abel did Nathaniel?
Hi, Raphael.
Hi.
Hey, Raphael.
Hi, Janice. Hi, Nicole. I went to the gym. I thought you were still rehearsing there. Nicole? Hey, Nicole, you okay?
I don't understand. I already saw him, but why is he... Raphael, I did tell him I was sorry.
Who? Did someone hurt you?
Yes. It's my dream boy. He got mad at me. He got mad at me, Raphael!
I was wondering why you were early. With a different costume. That's why she wasn't talking. That fraud!
Then why didn't you brought her some more when you had a feeling it was not us?
Because Estong asked me to tag along with him. And besides, if they were burglars pretending to be clowns, then what did they steal from you?
Steal what? Nothing is worth stealing here.
Oh, Vinny, I just pray that they didn't kidnap Nathaniel.
Yeah, just relax. Maybe he went out to play basketball.
I'm tired. I'm really tired of searching, Vinny.
Mother? What happened here?
Nathaniel!
Honey, instead of wasting your time over that medallion, why don't you start your own business? I'll take care of the capital.
Honey, you know I'm not good at that. But when I get that treasure, I'll never have to work or start a business as long as I live.
That's true, Leo, that's true.
What is that? The Yamashita treasure?
Leo, believe us. The legend of the medallion is true.
And how do you know that this is true, Alinda?
From my ancestors. Savannah's medallion came from them.
Okay, fine. If an expert proves to me that the legend is true, that indeed there's a map to where this treasure is, fine. Maybe I'll believe you then.
What happened here? Who did this?
Thieves broke in. They thought they could get something.
Where have you been, Nathaniel? I was so worried.
The company that I applied at, they called. They scheduled an interview.
Great. How'd it go? Were you hired?
No. I came in late. And look at me.
Yeah, what happened to you?
I tried to help this rich girl. Her car got stuck. Before I knew it, I got splashed with mud.
I hate myself. I hate myself. I hate myself. I hate myself.
Sis, are you okay?
Brother, this is bad. I already met my dream boy.
Are you serious? Really? Then what's wrong? Is he cross-eyed? Has bad breath? Has body odor?
No, brother. He's the cutest boy I've ever seen.
Then what's the matter with you?
I think I turned him off.
Oh, boy.
What will I do?
Savannah, I have great news for Leo.
Why, Mother?
I spoke to a friend of mine who's also into collecting antiques. She knows an expert, an archaeologist, and a professor. He surely knows a lot about medallions, about amulets and hidden treasures. I know his address. You better meet with him.
Those are just some of the necklaces I've collected since I was young.
Professor O'Neill?
Yes, may I help you?
I just came here to ask if you know anything about this particular medallion.
This is it. This is the other half of the medallion. that passes through each generation.
What else do you know about the medallion?
What's your name?
Savannah. Savannah Dio Gracia.
Are you a descendant of the Banal?
No.
Then, how did you get this medallion if you're not part of the Banal clan?
That came from my mother, who got it from her ancestors. It comes with a story that it will give anyone good fortune.
There's something you don't know about this medallion.
Which is why I'm here, so I would know. Tell me the story of the legend of the medallion.
The story of that medallion began a long time ago. It was molded and created by a father out of his love for his children. Blood, sweat, and tears were the price he paid to create the medallion, on which a map to a hidden treasure was skillfully carved. It is said that the treasure would be given to his children at the right time, a treasure that the Banal clan will share and inherit. The father gave the medallion to his children in exchange for the promise to love each other always. But greed overcame love in the hearts of the siblings. It showed the seeds of jealousy, rage, and hatred. It paved the way to great feud and rivalry between them that ended in tragedy, that the father just couldn't bear. The love he had for his children turned into pure hatred. As the medallion was torn to pieces, the father left his children with nothing but a lifelong curse. The curse brought a series of infinite pains and grave misfortunes upon them all, to the entire Banal clan. They will go through their lives filled with many challenges, experience great tragedies, loneliness, and a divided and never-ending search for the two pieces of the medallion. The broken medallion will be the sole reminder of their broken promise. Until the medallion is formed once again, the family will remain torn apart, and the curse will continue to haunt each generation. Since then, the medallion has been passed on continuously to families and became the source of conflict within the entire clan. Brother against brother. Family against family. And because of greed, each generation lived for nothing but the secret treasure it could bring them, the legendary treasure chest. What they fail to realize is that before they find the medallion, they need to recite the old chant engraved on it. This is the key to joining the pieces. And only then will they find the family's hidden treasure. But Savannah, even if you know everything about the medallion, all these things would still make no sense to you. You cannot make the medallion whole because you are not a descendant. You are not a Banal.
But if we're not descendants of the Banal clan, then who? Who are the Banal family?
When I learned of a woman looking for the medallion, whose name is Mira Cordero. I figured she could possibly be a descendant of the Banal clan. And I found out I was right, Savannah. When I saw the picture you took from her house, I saw Milagros Banal Cordero.
Hello, Miss Cassandra. Yeah, I'm calling you just to update you on what's going on here. Yeah, well, as usual, there are still some people who are opposing the policies we wish to implement. Uh-huh, but generally, the hotel is doing good. Except for a few minor problems with the people around here who want to see you. Sure, Miss Cassandra. I'll meet you at the coffee shop tonight. Okay, thank you.
Hello, Trudis? Okay. I'll be there.
Dagan.
Hey, Voltaire. What are you doing here?
We were deceived, Dagan. Cassandra's not in the States. She's here.
What?
Do you want to meet her?
Regarding the investigation concerning our financial problems, we're still working on it. If there are anomalies on financial statements, we'll let you know. Oh, Dagan's here.
Dagan, what are you doing here?
I'm supposed to meet a client.
A client?
Why? Do you doubt me?
No, Dagan.
And why are you having a meeting with my wife? She's no longer running the business.
Miss Cassandra asked me to bring her something.
And what is that?
It's girl talk. It's none of your business.
Anya, what are you doing here?
Well, Trudis asked me to pick her up. We're supposed to go shopping.
Anya, I'd like you to meet Casper. Cassandra's emissary. Casper, this is Anya.
It's nice meeting you, Casper.
Same to you, Anya.
For you?
What's this for?
Nothing. A good luck gift. Just something to inspire you to play your role.
Thanks.
Cheer up. You know, whoever this dream boy of yours is, forget him. I'm right here.
Huh?
Huh? Nothing. Just go ahead. Just do what you're doing. I'll be here.
Well, except for the mess, nothing's missing. So I think they really had no intention of stealing.
Vinny! Huh? A picture's missing.
Why would they steal that?
Savannah, my dear. Maybe that professor had inaccurate information.
Accurate or not, whether a descendant or not has any right to those treasures, I will still look for it. All my life, I hope for that treasure. So if Mira Cordero is a Banal, she better hide. Because I'll make her life a living hell.
I knew it! I knew it! He's going to meet with another woman. Maybe it's with White Flower. Anya, help me find that woman. I bet she's just right here.
Trudis, stop it! The guards are staring at us. Calm down!
No, I'm sure White Flower is right here.
Will you stop it? You won't be able to think straight if you're hysterical.
I'm sorry. It's possible that Abel may be behind this.
You should tell Nathaniel about it. Don't wait for him to ask any more questions about what's happening. So that if you finally see Abel, there wouldn't be any problem anymore. You'll be ready for it. I know it's hard for you, since you swore to break all ties with him. But you have to remain strong.
Oh, Dagen, did you see Cassandra? What does she look like? Is she attractive?
The next time, you better make sure you get your information straight.
Sis, this is the interpretation of your dream. Listen to this. The person that you dream about may be connected to your past, but not necessarily to your future. So if I were you, sis, that dream boy of yours ain't the only guy in the world. So cheer up, girl.
Son, Nathaniel, come here for a sec.
What's up, Mother?
Son, do you ever wish that we were rich? That aside from your mother, you wish you were also with your father?
I think about that sometimes. Sometimes I wish my father were here. So you would also have someone. But Mother, I do not regret growing up without a father. Because you're here. And Aunt Venny. You're my life, Mother. Especially when I see you happy, that makes me very happy too. And if my father is the reason why you're sad, then I promise I will never ask about him again. I never want you to get hurt.
Father said that, yes.
Don't do so.
What's going on?
Mother! Terry!
What is it?
I saw Don Lucio and my mother.
What? Did they see you?
No. I lost them. But I got their car's plate number.
Thank you for giving me a chance to talk to you before deciding on which hotel to invest in.
What exactly do you want, Mr. Iomonte?
Well, I want you to listen to me before making a big mistake. It's true that the news of Cassandra Madrigal's presidency caused quite a stir. But where is she now?
Casper's doing well.
He's just an assistant. Cassandra's still on top, but she cannot even make herself available, especially now that the company needs her. Now tell me, is that good leadership? I'm not asking you to pull out your investments from them. No. Well, not at the moment. What I want is for you to open your eyes. Can you actually trust an absentee president?
What's happening, Voltaire? The officers are getting restless. Two of our major investors are planning to back out.
Don't ask me. Why don't you ask the great Miss Cassandra Madrigal? Oh, right. She's not here. Nowhere to be found. Oh, there's Casper. Why don't you ask him?
Casper, I need to talk to you.
Regarding the investors? I already told Miss Madrigal about it. She's alarmed. What we don't understand is why these investors are worried when we're doing pretty well.
The problem is, they haven't met the president yet. And we can't be dealing with you all the time.
That's not the issue, Mr. Del Fuego. The real issue is that there are people who want to ruin the hotel's reputation. They're the traitors. And we have to find out who these people are. Excuse me.
Hi, please watch Romeo and Juliet. Thank you. Nathaniel?
Raphael.
Hey, how are you? Do you study here?
Yeah, you? How are you?
Well, still without a car.
So what's your father say?
Oh, long lecture. But we're okay now. What's up with you?
Me? I'm okay. You have a play?
Oh, not me, my friend. Actually, she's the lead. Oh, yeah. I haven't paid you back yet. If you want, I'll treat you to the play. Well, what do you say?
Sure.
Aunt Anya, the play's tonight. Please come, okay? Thanks, see ya.
Come on, let's go. You'll
okay.
Be late. Come on, let's go.
Nicole, Timothy. Where are you going?
Anya, I have some good news for you. Your mother's in the church.
Dad, I'm not asking for your support. That's why I didn't invite you. Because I know you'll say it's just a waste of time. But this is my life, Dad, and this is what I want. All I'm asking is, just let us be. Come on, brother.
Aunt Penny.
Why you?
Where's Mother?
She went to the market. You going somewhere?
Yeah. I have this new friend. He invited me. We watch a play. His treat.
Wow, a rich friend. It's your lucky day, I see.
Double time, Kay. Double time.
Hi, Nicole.
Hi, Raphael. This is my brother, Timothy. Raphael, my friend.
Oh, hi there.
Hi. Wow, you look great.
Thanks, Raphael. I'm still nervous right now.
Oh, don't be. Don't you know? You're the most beautiful princess I've ever seen.
You really know how to boost someone's morale. Thanks, Raphael. Hello? Aunt Anya?
Nicole, I'm really sorry, but I can't make it. Something really important came up.
Is that so? It's okay, I understand.
Okay, good luck to you. Break a leg.
Thanks, Aunt Anya. Bye.
Derry, I'm going to see Mother again. I've waited for so long for this moment.
But are you ready to face the past, Anya? If Don Lucio sees you, we don't know what he might do.
There's no reason for me to back out. Before, if he had the power to remove me from the picture, I'm not letting that happen again.
Aunt Penny, I'll be going now.
Okay. Can you get that first? Oh, for goodness sake.
Hello? Yeah? What? Nathaniel, your mother had an accident!
Hey, is your friend not here yet?
Not yet.
The play's about to start. Come on.
How are you, Mira? Do you feel better now?
I'm okay. The car hardly hit me.
Mother!
Sorry. Mira? What happened to you? Who? Was she the one who hit you?
No, tell me! Calm down, Fanny. Stop it. Everything's okay. I'm all right. She's very kind. I just got a bruise, but she still brought me here and she had me x-rayed.
I'm really sorry. There she is.
Mother?
Super.